Welcome to my world.
I know a place where we can go to lay the troubles down, eating your soul. I know a place where mercy flows. Take the stains, make you whiter than snow. Like a tide, it is rising up deep inside a current that moves and makes it come alive.
Good morning, everyone. Just in Surrey right now, on my way to get my load that's going to Calgary. Stayed the night over near the Tim Hortons, where I can get myself a breakfast sandwich and clean up in the morning, because they have a handicap bathroom there. I like the handicap bathrooms because you get the bathroom all to yourself. Last 3 days I spent with my daughter while I was serving my 3-day suspension. Because of speeding. Hopefully that's the last of the suspensions. I'm going to make a real effort to do my very best not to speed. Hopefully that's the last of that. But the thing is, you know, with the other companies I was with, if you're speeding, they never really said nothing about it. This company, they crack right down on it. Which, you know what, is a good thing, because it's a safety thing, right? It's a safety thing. And speed does cause accidents, so I'm not going to fault them on that at all. Okay, some new things that I'm doing again that I grabbed this weekend. I grabbed some barley mats. I'm back on that stuff again, which I'm really happy. Plus, I bought some multivitamins and energy. It's an energy pack. It's like a whole ton of multivitamins. In little packages, there's like maybe 8 pills in there, and you grain food and stuff to keep you hydrated, and it's pretty well for someone who's serious about working out. And I do work out every second day, but I thought it might be a good idea to pump myself up with some good multivitamins being out here on the highway and see if that makes a difference on my energy levels. And I grabbed some, I don't even like to use the word got. I also purchased some new skincare, some new jeans, some new shirts. And yeah, it was a pretty good week, except for this cold from hell that I have that doesn't seem to go away. It's a terrible cold. Now it's in my nose. So I've had this thing now for a good 2 weeks. It's just a miserable cold. So, that's one of the reasons why I also purchased the Barley Max again, because, and the multivitamins. I really, really, really want to be as healthy as I can, because these colds are no fun, especially when you're driving the highway. It is miserable. And I'm doing everything in my power right now not to cough. And I do have some stuff to share with you guys later on regarding, you know, what's been going on with me for the last week. It almost feels like God has not been anywhere near me for the last week. And I know He's been there with me. But I think He's allowing me, or allowed me, to feel like I was alone and by myself. So I turn to Him and rely on Him more. I felt like, you know, very important people in my life that meant a lot to me are no longer there, no longer are interested in even communicating with me very much anymore, or at all. And it's a real loss because I put a lot into my friendships and my relationships, and when people just, you know, they almost feels like they bail on you, it really, really hurts. And so it's almost like, Lord, I feel totally alone. I feel like there's no one here. Like, what's going on? I also gave up my e-cigarette, which was a companion in my life for 2 years. And I know that was my choice, but still, you give something up you're so used to having every single day, it is a loss. And you have to get used to that loss being gone and replace it with something else. And it's hard to replace an e-cigarette with something else because you just can't sit here and eat all day. So it's, you gotta change your mindset, right? So, and you know what? I really feel that the Lord allowed me, is allowing me to go through this loss. So I feel like He's stripping me completely down of every single thing in my life that either has been unfruitful or didn't bear any fruit or that was not good. And He's stripping me down, and that means people in my life, it means habits, etc., etc., etc. And He's going to change me into something new for a bigger and better purpose. And I'm looking forward to that, and I'm excited about that. So, it'll be interesting to see what this week is like. Last week was really miserable for me. It was really lonely. It was very sad. And I hope this week is a bit better. This morning I woke up, and I actually felt the presence of God with me. And I'm like, oh, Lord, there You are. Where have You been? And maybe He was just wanting to see what I was going to do. I had several temptations this week. You wouldn't believe, but I said no to all of them. And I just said, no, Your grace is sufficient. And I'm going to trust in You. And I don't give myself credit for winning over those temptations. I give God the credit for giving me the power and the willpower, the strength to say no to them. And I pray that this week is also another successful week for me regarding my spiritual strength. Okay, well, I'm going to go inside here and see if this load's done. Okay, I'm ready. Finally. I looked at the cams, I checked out the weather forecast all the way up to Calgary. It should be a nice drive all the way up, and I hope it is. And this particular video, like, you guys will remember that I used to do videos before where I would highlight maybe one road trip. But what I've done, as you guys probably have noticed, and that is I have pretty well provided highlights of an entire cycle in one video. And that just gives you an idea on what I did for that particular week. And I hope you like that format a little bit better. And that's kind of what we're doing. So if I'm not, there's not a whole lot that happens during the day, or any of the days, I'll select a few little highlights here and there. And I don't want to, you know, I don't want to bore you guys, but I want to give you still an update on what's going on and, you know, about the day. Some days are a little bit more exciting than others, some are a little bit more boring, right? So that's what it's like with this job. So I can't slide the pin on my trailer, so it's about two or three notches off of where I would like it. I hope I can get through a scale and they don't get mad at me, because you're supposed to have your 48 mark, 48 foot. Oh, I can't remember now. My head is a fog. Anyway, there's an area where you're supposed to have your axles lined up to a legal spot where it is out here. I can't remember what it is in my head now. I just don't use that enough for me to remember. But anyway, It's very hard for me to think. It's very hard for me to even talk right now because I feel like I'm talking through my nose. And when I get colds, they love to get me in the nose. And I thought for sure giving up the cigarettes and giving up the vapor cigarette would help that, but I don't know. My situation doesn't seem to made any difference. I'm sure it is. I'm sure my immune system is a lot stronger. 195 Street. I'm sure my immune system is a whole lot stronger, but still, it's just not very pleasant. Yeah, so yeah, I don't even know what I'm even saying right now. You'll get the highlights of the entire cycle. That's what you do. Some, if it's really nice weather, this, you know, I'm going to show you that it's really nice and smooth sailing, and little highlights all the way up there, and that's what I'll give you. Anyway, I'm a rambling man. I can't remember the other lyrics because I'm on top of the world. And I'll be so happy when this cold is gone. I'm super tired today. This cold has drained me. Like the last couple days I stayed with my daughter. Didn't get a whole lot of sleep. I spent more time choking and coughing. It was very, very miserable. I mean, I tried to enjoy my time with her, but it wasn't very much fun when I'm waking up 3 or 4 times a night, coughing and coughing and coughing. And a little fever here, a little fever there, a little fever everywhere. So I'm tired. There's a couple times I've had a real hard time staying awake today. That's one of the reasons why I stopped in Golden to get a bite to eat. Because I wanted to make sure I could I wanted to make sure I didn't fall asleep. What's going on here? What is this guy doing? I guess he decided not to do that turn. Okay. Is it already my... Come on, truck. Let's go. Wow. Can't even get out. Oh, jeez. You're kidding. Come on, baby. Let go. Atta boy. Let go of my ego. Jeez. Didn't want to let me go. Spinning and spinning and spinning. Oh man, I hate talking with a plugged up voice like this. My whole nasal passage feels stuffed. Oh well. Oh. Now the cough. This is the way it was for me. Two solid days, non-stop coughing like that, and not, and all the coughing was absolutely accomplishing nothing. It wasn't clearing anything up. Anyway, folks, there's not much else to report except a lot of coughing, I'm sure. A plugged nose, a lot of coughing, and that's about it. So I'm going to call it a night and I'll see you guys in the morning. Well, I had a very interesting rest last night. I feel a little bit better. My lungs are clearing up a little bit more, which is a real plus. And I had three dreams last night. One that I got into a truck and started driving away and it was not mine. I thought it was mine, but it wasn't. Just really funny, innocent dreams. I had a dream the other day, about a week ago. I never did tell you guys about. I was driving my truck and I was driving up a steep hill. It was a mountain. And it kept getting steeper and steeper and steeper. And then as I'm driving up, I'm looking out my window and I can see the clouds. You know, that I'm passing like clouds. I couldn't see, you know, the terrain anymore. I was level with the clouds. And I'm like, wow. And I'm driving, and I'm driving, and I'm driving, and all of a sudden, I'm going higher and higher and higher, and it's getting steeper and steeper to the point where I almost felt like I was laying on my back. And I'm like, oh my goodness, if this gets any steeper, I'm going to flip this truck over. And I can't stop and turn around because I'll flip it for sure. So I got to just keep going. So I'm doing about 20 kilometers an hour up this hill. It was so steep. Like I said, I felt like I was laying on my back. It was quite a rush. Especially even in a dream. And then all of a sudden I seen all this cloud, this fog in front of me, but it was clouds, it wasn't fog. And I was passing through these clouds, I'm getting even higher up. And now I can't see where I'm going at all because of the cloud. And I'm like, okay, I'm just going to keep going straight because I don't know where else I can go. I can't turn, I can't see where I'm going. And then I finally got through it and I got to the top and there was a home on the top. It was a mount, like it was like a little farm, and it was on the top of the mountain. And I looked around and it looked like there was a driveway and there was a garden. And then my alarm clock woke me up and I'm like, rats! I would have liked to know, you know, where that dream would have led. But you know what? Maybe God was trying to tell me something. Maybe he was trying to tell me there's something very, very good for you on the top of that mountain. Just keep climbing it, Ray. Don't turn around. Don't look back. Don't try to allow anything to make you fall back. Because while I was in that dream, there's a part of me that wanted to turn around, wanted me to stop. And I just said, no, I got to keep going. Even though I was scared, even though I was worried in that dream about you know, continuing on because it was so steep, I didn't stop. Maybe God was trying to tell me, you're almost there, Ray, you're almost on the top of the hill. Then once you get up there, we can start working on you. And you can start seeing things unfold in your life. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe he was trying to tell me that, I just don't know. I hope so. It was a pretty cool dream, though. I talked to my buddy Sean. He says he's had dreams like that before. I went, oh, really? Well, regardless, whatever the Lord has planned, I trust him. Okay, I really don't know what I have for a load, people. Don't have a load yet, but I got to go over to the safety manager and fill out a waiver to let him know that I haven't had any speeding tickets, or because every few months or whatever, we're supposed to report if we had any speeding tickets. Well, it's been more than 3 months. Started work here in July. 6 months. We're supposed to report if we had any speeding tickets or violations or whatever, and if we haven't, we're supposed to go in there and let them know we haven't and signed a waiver to, you know, giving our word that nothing's on our record. So that's what I got to do right now. So until I get a load, that's about all I got. All I got to do right now, so I'll go take care of that. All right, I'm a happy camper. It is. My load's not supposed to be ready until like 7 o'clock. 2:30, and it's done. I like that. I hate waiting around. Awesome. My delivery time is for 2:30 tomorrow afternoon. New, it's gonna get there tonight. I don't know when tonight, but the dispatcher said that my load is supposed to be there tonight. These guys are telling me that I got until tomorrow to do it. A lot of crossed wires. All right, let's go and verify and make sure that this is actually it. I can usually tell by the seal that's on it. There's two seals here. Oh, I see. I have to close up. The guy at the gate's got to seal it. So it should be at bay 205. Oh, this is nice. I thought I was going to be stuck here for at least a couple more hours at least. And this should be the trailer right here. Right here. Okay, well, as you can tell, we made it to Salmon Arm. Man, it was pretty ugly going through the pass there. Hey, Harry? It was just ugly because everyone was going so slow. Okay, all done here over in Salmon Arm. Making my way to Vernon now. That's a good 40-minute drive. Something like that. Almost an hour,
it says. 6.5 kilometers. Turn right on Highway 9070.
Another check engine light came on again. All the same errors I had before. ABS, traction control, check engine light, call Peterbilt. Same problem I had last time, I'm having it again. 3 times in a row now, I keep getting the same problem. So, I think it's just a sensor, so I'm gonna ignore it. A lot of these are sensor issues, so I'm just gonna ignore it. Should be all right. Not gonna let it bother me now. Okay, well, I should be in Vernon by 11. Hopefully I can maybe make up a little time getting there. They got like 9 pallets to unload, so. No, wait a minute, no, they got more than that. They got like 13 pallets to unload. Hopefully they have a place to put them all. And maybe I'll have an opportunity to get a bite to eat while they're doing that. I doubt it though. A lot of the time they want you sitting in there watching them. I don't know why. And if that's the case, I'm just gonna tell them, well. whatever. Anyway, I'm tired. I don't want to feel like, don't even feel like talking right now, people. Let's just go. Several hours, or will it take 15-20 minutes for them to unload it? No.
In 300 meters, arrive at Vernon Walmart on the right.
Hey, well, I'm done for the night. I'm just parked over here in Vernon. I was going to park over at the Walmart parking lot, but they have this huge big sign that they don't allow any overnight parking of any sort. A lot of the other Walmarts, they'll allow you to park right in the parking lot because their parking lots are pretty big and they allow RVs to park there, but not that one there. They don't let anybody park there. So, that's my cue. Find another place to park. So I'm not quite sure what's going to be happening for me tomorrow. I'm going to call my dispatcher in the morning after my 8 hours off. It's midnight now, so I ain't going to be leaving anywhere until at least 8 o'clock. But 7 o'clock, I should be able to have some idea of what's going on. Maybe I'll have some clue if they have a load that I can turn and burn with. That would be really nice, so we'll see. Okay, folks, that's all I got for you tonight. I'll see you in the morning. Glad this day's over. And I will admit, my cold is getting better. Thank you, Lord. Well, good morning, everyone. It is 11 o'clock. Yeah, it's a little later than usual. Doesn't mean I got up at 11 o'clock. I was up this morning at 8, got my 8 hours of rest, and had an opportunity to have breakfast with my sister Marilyn, which was really, really nice. I don't have a whole lot of opportunities to do that, so that was a huge blessing. It was really nice. Love spending.
Friend, the waiting days are over.
I love spending time with my sister. She's a good woman, a woman of God, who's seeking after God's own heart, and I really respect her a lot. And Marilyn, I don't know if you're watching this video, if you ever watch any of the videos that I put out, but I have the highest respect for you. I really do. And it's been a real wonderful blessing to spend this time with you this morning and have breakfast with you. It was nice. So now, I'm just gonna make my way back to the newest yard. I called ahead of time and asked if they had a load that they could turn, I could turn with. Make my way back to when I get to New Westminster. I don't know if they'll have something for me. Guess we'll find out soon enough. And go from there. Coquella Summit right now. Just want to give you guys an update. They not much to show you, just the regular route. It's actually raining up here. It's like 5 degrees. It's supposed to rain tonight too up here, which is a good thing because I do have another load to pick up at the yard at 7 p.m. tonight. Hopefully it'll be done by 7 and I can head back and make it as far as Kamloops, and then 7 hours to Calgary from Kamloops. If it gets done sooner, then maybe I'll go as far as Sorrento, maybe. I don't know, we'll see what happens. It's an overnight load. It needs to get there as soon as possible, but there's not much I can do if the load isn't ready. So they more or less told me, we're gonna give you this load. It's up to the guys at the dock to get it done sooner. Your responsibility is just get the load there as fast as you can to the yard. We know you're gonna have to sleep tonight, so there's no pressure. So the nice thing about it, I don't have to sit in the west tonight. You can go down there, grab a load, do a turn, head back. I really do like that. So that's what I plan to do. So that's what's going on. I love going down this hill with an empty trailer. Don't have to worry about weight, don't have to worry about snow. I love, or should I say, I love going down this hill with an empty trailer when the roads are like this. Yeah, so it's about 4 to 5 degrees out here. And it's kind of nice, we're almost done. We're almost through January. We got 2 more months after this to go. More or less 2 more months of winter, and then we'll be through, and then we'll start making our way into spring. And I can't tell you how much I'm looking forward to that. I love the spring. I love the spring and I love the fall. Summer I like too, but it's the new growth, and when you start seeing everything, all the leaves changing colors, that's what I like. Good morning, everyone. I know it's early. Okay, 2321226R. Unfortunately, I was supposed to, I didn't get a chance to leave last night because just they were short of people last night on the dock. They couldn't load this load. And I figured, you know what, it'd be a better thing for me just to sleep and then get up as soon as my body woke me up and then go. My body woke me up at 3 a.m. and I think I fell asleep maybe at 9. I think I must have been pretty close to 9. So I got about 6 hours of sleep.
But yeah, it's no more than 200 yards, maybe a little bit better than that out here to the west of Buddle.
Well, we got some kind of an accident up here, something just west of Flood Hope Road. I don't know if traffic's getting through here or not, though, or if we're sitting at a standstill. So what exactly happened up here?
A rock came down.
Rock came down.
Come over from the eastbound side and later over on the westbound side, right on the north shoulder there.
Oh, okay, thanks, drivers. I guess some rocks came down or something. I guess.
Flood hole.
Yeah, some rocks.
Before the flood hole exit.
So I guess some rocks came down. I wonder if anybody hit them. Hopefully not. I mean, that would be a bit disastrous. Especially on a, you know, a time like this where you really can't see a whole lot. It's dark and it's raining and all of a sudden you see this big boulder sitting in front of you. That's not very, that's not a pleasant way to wake up. Hopefully they get some of the rocks cleared off the road and we can be on our way.
Okay, I just,
eastbound scale, Kamloops. I am tired. I am really tired. Six and a half hours of sleep, and when I got stopped over there in Hope because of the rock slide, I fell asleep for half an hour, and the cop, I guess I fell asleep, and the whole line started to go finally at 6:30, and this cop came up, and he was going, whoop, 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 trying to get my attention to wake me up. I'm like, oh, sorry. Anyway. Look at this weather, eh? Almost at the summit of Rogers Pass. It's snowing pretty nice up here. Flakes are big. Why am I sitting here, you ask? Avalanche control. And the girl over there just told me could be sitting here for 2 hours. Isn't that nice? Wow, nothing but delays today. First, it's the rock slide. And now this. So now I gotta get a hold of dispatch and let them know that I was gonna be there by 6 o'clock Calgary time, but now it looks like it could be delayed until 8 o'clock because of avalanche control. They're not gonna be happy, but what can you do, right? What can you do? Here's another TransX truck. Maybe I'll get lucky and they'll let me through sooner, but I don't think that's going to happen. It's funny, I looked on Drive BC, it said 2:30 when it started. It's only 12. I don't know why it's going now. Okay, I'm going to give dispatch a call, give them the good news. And then maybe in the meantime, I'll just work on a video. Sorry about that. Whew. Wow, what a fun 2 weeks this has been. Okay, dropped my trailer. Finally got everything here. Everyone's happy. Yes, the load is several hours late. That's really not my fault because I got the trailer when I got it. Come on, will you just get in here? Oh. But I'm done early and I am going to head over to Walmart and pick up a loaf of bread. Maybe something warm to eat for tonight. I usually have my butter chicken, but you know what? I'm starting to get sick of that. I want something different. I'll tell you what I really have a craving for. I got a craving for pizza. Oh. Come on. It's 8 degrees out here. It's really warm out here. And the snow is melting in the yard. Isn't that special? You don't see that very often in Calgary during this time of the year. All right, I'm calling it a night. I'm gonna relax. And I'll talk to you guys in the morning. Well, good morning. It's still morning here. It's noon. 12:44, so good afternoon. It is Friday now, and I'm over at the Walmart DC, and just waiting for a load right now. This load that I have is going to be an interesting run. Probably one of the more interesting runs I've had in a long time. It's scheduled to go to Trail or Cranbrook, then Trail tonight. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. If I can get out of here by 2 o'clock Calgary time, I may be able to do it. I don't know. Gonna do my very best, but yeah, it's going to Cranbrook and then to Trail, and then from Trail I gotta take number 3 all the way to Hope, And during this time of the year, Crow's Nest is very, very treacherous. It's very, very, very windy. It's very slippery. There's a lot of mountain passes. It's gonna be an interesting run, to say the least. So that's what I have to look forward to. And I'm just waiting right now. They just started loading my trailer, and hopefully they'll have it loaded pretty quick. They usually do pretty, you know, they're pretty good here. Doesn't take them long. They have their motorized, they have their forklifts and that. They load up pretty quick. They know what they're gonna load. So right now it's 12:49 my time, so I'm hoping that they'll have this. So it's 1:49 Calgary time. So I'm hoping they'll have that loaded at least within an hour, and I can be out of here within an hour and a half. That's what I'm hoping for anyway. Don't know if that's gonna happen. So this is gonna be a very, very interesting video, I have a feeling. The rest of it anyway, so. Hope you guys find it entertaining. Hope you find it entertaining. I looked at some of the cams going through some of the summits along Crow's Nest. Didn't look very pretty. Looks a little ugly. So we'll have to see. We'll have to see. The Lord's going to be helping me find my way through there. Yeah. So in the meantime, I'm just going to work on a video, relax a little bit. I read a psalm this morning that was really, really nice. I actually read several psalms this morning, but the one I read was Psalm 25. Perhaps I'll share it with you later. I said that last time, didn't I? I didn't get around to the other one either. But I kind of read it as almost like a prayer. All right, I'm on my way. I am really gonna try for Cranbrook tonight. See if I can get there tonight and do my delivery. I think the last time I went to Cranbrook, they would not let me stay there in the yard or the loading dock. So if they don't, I guess I'll pull out of there and just find somewhere on the side of the road to sleep for the night. Hopefully get to bed by 10 p.m. I'm hoping to get there by maybe 9:30. They only have like 3 pallets to unload. They don't have very many. So that's my plan tonight anyway. I am not gonna make it to trail, and I'm gonna have to let them know that. I'm gonna give them a call and let them know. Can't make it to trail. I'll be doing that appointment in the morning. And I'm gonna do everything in my power to get to Cranbrook. So, see what awaits us. Hopefully the chain up will not be in effect on Kootenay Pass tomorrow morning. But if it is, I guess we'll just have to deal with it. So let's make our way to Cranbrook. Cranbrook looks a little different than the last time I came out here. It's pretty white out here, but it's only 0 degrees out here, so it's not very cold. funny thing is,
turn right on McPhee Road.
Is that from here I will be heading west on Highway 3, and I have never been that way before. So this is going to be a new adventure here for me. I'm going to have to stop here and let these guys know I'm here. Still have my banana. I got a banana and a pear at a truck stop. So looking forward to eating that. I just decided, you know what, I just almost threw it on the ground. I just decided, you know what, I really want to start eating healthier. I just do. I actually eat pretty healthy, but I want to eat healthier. Eat more vegetables and fruits, and taking my supplements now. The trick is, or not the trick, how about I reword that? The goal is to be in the best shape of my life, mentally, spiritually, and physically, by the time April rolls around. That's my goal. So I've got a couple months. Couple months to get things together. Okay, what time is it? Oh wow, look at that timing. 9 o'clock. Gotta like that. And it'll probably take them, let's see here, a whole 5-10 minutes to unload this thing. They only got 3 skids to take out. So that should be interesting. So 9 o'clock. I thought the road, you know, the ride up here was going to be a lot. I thought it was going to be more difficult than it really was. But I looked at the cams and they look white, like it looked like a whiteout coming up here, and it wasn't all that bad. But I am guessing it's going to be a lot different going the other way. Cranbrook. Okay. Let's give a knocky knock on the door and let these guys know I'm here. Okay, I'm done here in Cranbrook. And I'm now heading westbound on Highway 3. Not sure how far I'm going to get because, well, technically, I don't know what the roads are going to be like on the way to trail. I mean, by the time I get the trail, it's going to be like 12:30. And I think I'm going to go as far as I can before the midnight hour rolls around, so I don't have to do another pre-trip and logbook thing and all that stuff. Besides, I don't know what the weather is going to be like either. It could be really lousy too. I mean, I looked at some of the cams and it doesn't look very pretty. So this is all brand new. This is uncharted territory for me. I've never been this far west of Highway 3 past Cranbrook. I've been on Crowsnest from Princeton to Hope. Penticton. Yeah, I've been that way through Princeton and then to Hope, but not this. I've never been through here, where it takes you through Trail and Castlegar and all these other areas. I've never been through that way. So this is all brand new for me. So I'd hate to drive through it at night and not be able to at least enjoy some of the scenery. But I'm gonna go as far as I can until my gut tells me to stop for the night. So let's make our way and see how far we go. Hey, well, this is the first little town I'm approaching here. I think it's called Moyer, I believe. M-O-Y-I-E, or it's Moye. And I'm guessing this is probably a really small little town. Wow, it's pretty white around here. Hopefully the roads don't get too... I'd really like to stop for the night before I end up in a chain-up area. I mean, if I gotta dig my chains out, I wanna do it when I can see what I'm doing. Because I'd have to pull everything out of my jockey box just to get to my chains. And I don't wanna be doing that in the dark. I wanna be able to do that when I can see. If I had chain racks, that'd be different, but I don't. This can't be the end of the town. I haven't seen anything yet. I guess that was it. Wow, that's a tiny little town. Okay. Now you see it, now you don't. All right, onward we go. I think the next town is Creston. And I don't know if I'm going to go as far as that. I might, I don't know. We'll see what happens. But on our right-hand side, you can't really see it, but there's a lake over there. That's Moye Lake. That's over there. Man, I wish I could see this during the day. But you know what? I know there will be opportunities during the day and in the springtime and the summertime to come through here because this is a regular route. Not much to see right now, though. Well, I made it into Creston. And now the trick here is find a place I can actually pull over. But not knowing the area, I really don't know where I can pull over. The only thing I can hope for is that there's an area where I see a couple other trucks, and then at least I'll know, right? And if you guys are familiar, if you're from Canada, I don't know if they sell kokanee beer out in the U.S. Canada that are familiar with kokanee, this is where they brew it, right here in Creston. This is where they brew it. And I think the brewery is not too far from here. I think it's pretty close by, actually. I might be right on top of it here somewhere. I'm sitting passing by here, I'm like, oh man, wouldn't it be nice if there was an A&W around here? And look what I find. I found a place that's got overnight parking. Or should I say, I found a place here with an A&W. And it says here, no overnight parking. You know what? I'm parking here anyway. What's the worst they're gonna do? They're gonna wake me up if I'm taking up any space. But I'm sure there's a few other drivers, trucks that park here. Thank you. at the Creston Valley Mall. And there's a Marks here. There's Creston Valley Insurance, and there's an A&W right here, and there's an Overweighty Foods there. I guess this is probably one of the more major malls around here. The nice thing about it is I can get breakfast in the morning and be on my way quickly. So I'm okay with that. I'm happy to hear that. I wonder if the chain up is still in effect. So 11 o'clock I got here, so can't really go anywhere now until 7. We're now 7:15. So let's check the chain up. See if that's still in effect. Rats, it is. I don't know where this is all. You know, I don't mind, like I said, I don't mind putting chains on the truck, but I gotta dig them out of my jockey box, and that's a real pain in the butt. Oh well, if I have to, I have to. Maybe I'll be fortunate. Maybe the morning will come around and I won't have to do it. Maybe the Well, we'll see what happens. But I'm not gonna worry about it right now. I'm gonna get some rest, get some sleep, and have a go at it in the morning. See you in the morning, guys. Good morning, everyone. It is 7:40 and I'm just checking here to see what Kootenai Pass looks like, because that's where I'm heading. And I'd like to know whether or not they still chaining up or not. Oh man, I can't wait till this is over. I think I'm going to be like, you know how you see the Chinese people, they walk around with a mask on their face? I think that's going to be me soon. So the Calgary Highway, man, did they ever get, they got dumped on, severely dumped on. And they're still getting dumped on. I may end up going, well, I won't have to go through there. I'm going to end up going through the whole Princeton Highway 3, which is probably going to be just as bad. Anyway, I'm trying to find, come on, where is it here? Help me out here. Oh, of course I passed it. There it is. Okay, we got other trucks stopping here. One guy went by, he said it wasn't too bad. He said they had the chain up lights on, but guys had, there was lots of gravel and guys were making it up the hill. Anyway. So there it is there. I don't know if you can even see it all that well, because it's probably out of focus. But that is the Kootenai Pass there. It looks like we got a couple guys there that are stopped. Now the trick is to see if the chain lights are still on. And sometimes this is not quite, yeah. It says they're still on, so I don't know. You know what, we'll find out when we get there. We'll ask a couple other drivers, and if they're making it up and down the hill okay, then I will try to. If I can avoid putting those chain ups or chains on, I will, because, like I said, I don't want to drag them out of jockey box. It's just a real, because I gotta find a place to put all my other stuff. And that's not gonna be fun. So, let's make our way to Kootenai Pass and see what we're in for. Dear Lord, I thank you for this morning. You're an awesome God, and in you I put all my trust. I ask you, Lord, to please give me safe passage home today. I'm going to be taking Highway 3. You know all about it. You created that beautiful terrain. And Lord, I just pray that you would please help me to make my way there safely, and that I would respect the people on the road, and that they would respect me. Lord, please I also pray that you would protect me from hitting any of your animals and protect the animals on the road as well. Dear Lord, I love you and I put all my trust in you. And I also ask you, Lord, to please bless and watch everyone watching this video right now. You know their needs, Lord. You know their desires. And Lord, I pray that you would just guide them. Give them discernment and wisdom, Lord, to prepare, to be prepared for the coming kingdom. In Yeshua's name I pray, amen. Good judgment call. I went down this road. I had no idea where it went. And look where it led me, right in behind here. Gotta like that. So here's the loading dock area. Yeek. All right, I am done with trail. Happy camper, because I got these two loads done. Considering yesterday when I started making my way towards Cranbrook, there was like three different chain up areas that were in effect, and it was just pure ugliness. And I was talking to this guy here at the Walmart, and he says the other drivers told him it was a real nightmare. Wow, it's ever beautiful out here. I love exploring these areas that I've never been at before. Trail is really gorgeous. Wow. I can't wait to see this in the summertime, springtime. And just to make things a little bit more fun, when this spring and summer rolls around, I'm going to think of it as my final year on the road. That's what I'm gonna think of it as, and I know you guys are thinking, really, is it going to be? You know what, I don't know, it could be. I don't know what the Lord's got in store for me. But at least if I think of it that way, I will take more of my time to enjoy myself this summer and springtime. You just don't know what God's gonna do, right? So I'm guessing the roads are probably going to be quite ugly. open. It's still chained up at Box Canyon and on the Calgary Highway. And if it's chain up is required there, it's probably really snowing really bad in that area. So I'm guessing the Hope Princeton is probably not any better. But I checked there and chain up is not in effect there, but that could change later on too, right? So we'll just enjoy the ride and see what happens on the way. That's all I can do, right? Absolutely. Look at all the residential and commercial area right in front there. It's all on the hill. Look at this huge big factory here. I don't know, that must be a pulp mill or something. It's massive. Look at how big that is. That is so big. The trail is actually quite big. This must be the downtown core right around here. Yeah, that's a pretty big factory. I don't know. Not exactly sure what that is. Well, I'm back over in New Westminster, or should I say I'm at the Petro Pass in Coquitlam. I dropped off my trailer and grabbed a little bit of food, and now I'm gonna settle in for the night and just relax. I was having a really, really good day today, and then towards the end of it, it just turned upside down on me. The enemy has a very unusual way of, unpredictable ways of hitting you and hitting you hard. But you know what, I guess I'll just have to put up with it and have to tolerate it. But I really do hope you guys enjoyed the video, the drive through along Highway 3. I found it very, very, it was nice. It was very beautiful and it was really nice. And some of the little towns like Rossland, what a nice little town that was that we went through. But I hope you enjoyed the video. And until we do it again, God bless all of you. In the name of Yeshua, please keep me in your prayers. And I'll be praying for you.